Okay, so second part, storage. I'm not really happy about using maps for storage. I want something more contiguous, like a vector or an array, but something that still like has a consistent. Yeah, I'm just looking for contiguous storage of some sort. I need a new one, so I'll call it like let's see if we can create a nice storage thing. Now I'm going to, first of all, I'm thinking of like a variadic template. Def and def. Template, just type name, types. So when we create storage, we are going to have to specify like the capacity. We have an array. Of, sorry, pointers, void pointers, the size of the number of types we have. Where is this declared? C standard def. When we're creating a storage, let's say for the constructor, capacity, we have to start with a capacity of some sort. We also have a destructor for storage. Do we want a copy? Probably not. We can move it around. No, I don't want to delete it. Then let's see, how do I want to get stuff back out? If I have multiple types, x equals 0, because I can't rely on the type. What if, like, if the types in the array is like an int and an int and an int, I can't just say template type and then retrieve that type, because it could be any of the three types, any of the three stored arrays. So I need to actually, like, go in by index instead. No accepts. It'll return like a really weird type. If this is a multiple thing, so let's say storage int int32t and double int32t. Restoring arrays of these together. And we have the index. That means we can use, what is it? Something to do with tuples. Tuples. Pair tuple. Okay, this is it. Does this require a tuple? Yeah, probably. Yeah. So the index, standard tuple of types. Pointer. Type name. So we'd return and that would be automatic. It's a void pointer, so that'd be converted into that type. We do the same thing here. For the const version. So that just kind of leaves the constructor and destructor. And the moving. Well, moving's not so bad, actually. If there's no capacity, just return them all as null pointers. Otherwise, we need to build. Let's say this is are these like multiple or singular? Let's just say they're multiple allocations. So, do I want to like is do I want to like if I call new that's going to call constructors, which some items may not have those. It may be blank. It may be better to do a good old-fashioned malloc free instead. Just uninitialized memory. I just need the memory. I don't need it initialized. So I need the allocation size. So it'll be capacity times size of. How do I say this? So basically, be like this. But that's local type. Not really going to work. Like, this is not going to. Okay, malloc is missing because that's from C string. Okay, cool. Read of non-const is not allowed a constraint expression. Okay. I'm not entirely sure how I'm supposed to do. I'm going to do this. Figure out the capacity of each subtype. Okay, is there another way I can do this? Build, okay, what if there's, if I can build up an, okay. Something like this, something that returns standard tuple. Size T, or rather, just a standard array. Times size of and it's like a type name or template. Index of 0. And then we can go down iteratively through these. So not capacity array, but Alex size array. Inside of here, create an array. Types. Okay. Then we return return array. But we need to, hmm. index equals 0. And we have this, if we put it, pass in as a reference. And then we go through each of them. Okay, the current type equals this. If const expression index not equals size of types minus 1. So if it's not the end, then okay, so times index 0 1, yeah, then we call alloc size 1 or index plus 1 with capacity and the allocation size array. That should recursively go through. So once we have this, I'm thinking that we have an array of all the capacities in an array that we go here, then we got, then we can go through for size t size less than size of that or m buffer size, whatever. Okay, and then destructor. Just going to go through. It actually doesn't even matter. We just got to go through them all. Four. Pointers. Okay. Let's create another. Capacity. Does it even compile? No. Alex, not for, are you serious? Okay. C standard lib. Okay, I need to go into test. I want to make sure. So we have the capacity of one. We have the allocation size array, which is both zero. That's not quite right. At all. Oh, yes. I never actually... That's even worse. Oh no, it's there. 4 and 8. Okay. Okay. And then we create allocations of those sizes. filled with garbage data, but they are there. See if we can get some more interesting stuff to do with storage. Let's actually rename this to like multi. Yeah. Array, standard def, standard lib, tuple. Okay. This would imply that there'll be a single allocation storage where it's all the array data is in one single large allocation instead of multiple smaller ones. Because in the end, I'm allocating just about the same amount of space, just one can be done in one allocation. So one column alloc instead of like several. Although in the end, I'm not really sure if there'll be much benefit. Single template. This first one will basically be like an old-fashioned array, essentially. So not really much point. double, say a string. Let's get some more crazy advanced types in here. So double. Yeah, it doesn't really matter for these advanced types. Four. Back here I had cannot initialize return type with an L value of that. These are all void stars. Okay, int star with an L value of okay, void star. Okay, I need to static cast it. I'm actually interested in if this folds down as I would think it would. So let's go to this. Can I grab this stuff? Okay. See, 0, 1, 2. They all have their own things, but if it's under optimization, oh, of course, because test doesn't actually return anything. Okay. Oh, yes, dash O two again. Okay, that's because of that. But let's say it takes in an int type capacity. Then we put the capacity in. M buffers. Okay, hold on. This is a jump one where it just sets them all to zero because it's three pointers, so it uses larger words. Otherwise, yeah, it's just like one thing each because it's basically folded these into nothing. Better with that. 01. It doesn't use XMM anymore. But of course, if it's like that, then it's a lot slower because it's got a whole bunch more stuff it's doing at the same time. Avoids what? Okay. Auto, that makes it. And again, like it, each one of these 0, 1, 2, 3, and if I have like. Like the number of these things doesn't really matter. I mean, it does in unoptimized, where it becomes, whoa, a lot more. Alex size 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. But as soon as you pile on any optimization at all, it just, yeah, it goes down to basically nothing. Some kind of pre-calculated something or other. Line as 256. we add test onto the end? Yeah, it's just, it compiles down to basically nothing. Okay, so this storage could actually work pretty well. I mean, it's a lot of template nonsense, but it compiles down really nicely. Okay, I'll add more tests for this one later, offline. Or actually, no, I should at least make sure I can actually generate. Is there really anything other than constructors? I'll have to do the move constructor, that's one, yeah. Okay. So let's get these move constructors done while we are here. Or move constructor, move operator. The others. Okay, so in capacity. Them out of the way. Let's do this to auto, so that makes it a bit easier. So, if this not equals other, Okay, so that's everything in here. So there's a whole bunch of parallel storage, malloc, so not zeroed, not nude, not initialized, I should say. So that makes me interested. I want to do like another one, which is a single allocation storage. Should be very similar, except instead of like creating multiple separate arrays in memory, it's all going to be one larger one with it, like the different types segmented in parts of the same array. Like how you would normally do, I guess, an image or texture storage, where you'd have this like the mipmaps underneath in the same one large allocation. I mean, I'm not really entirely sure how, like, if there's even a benefit, but it'll be interesting. Okay, let's see if I can actually take these out of here as well, while I'm at it. Like this. Redefinition, yeah. Okay, very, very, very close, almost the same. So these are basically the same, almost the same, except in, of course, we don't need to do this. We just need to do this for the first one. Free M buffers 0. I still want to keep like the where the different types start, but I only need to worry about the single allocation, which means only the first pointer. Now, this one is a bit different. Building an allocation size array. I'll need to return like a size T. I'm going to need like. No. Yes, maybe. Yeah, I still need the allocation size array because. I'll need it to determine them where to put the pointers afterwards. But I still need the total size allocation. No, I can just use that thing for the whole so total size allocation. Just by putting them together. Okay, alloc size array. This is basically the same, except m buffers 0 equals malloc of the whole thing. Okay. Whatever, we'll just temp that out for the moment. Down here. Okay, this is the same. This will be different. Okay, let's change this up. So it's returns, whoops, of a size t, which is the total size plus the arrays. I'm gonna do both. Leave that for the moment, or rather, so it'll be what size plus alloc offset, alloc. Yeah. I'm going to have to do some kind of alignment business, I'll bet. Because the idea here is that if we have like a version that's 4 And we end like 4 bytes before at a good at like 8 byte alignment, and we next item wants an 8 byte alignment of some sort. Then we'll want to have it shifted over. So adding an extra 4 bytes to the end of the last one, even if we're not going to use them. Memory nonsense is going to. Okay. Index type equals this. We'll have the current size. Offset array, full bytes. Going to change this up to be like the offset array. We're going to build the offset array. So it'll be the offset from the starting point. Is what matters. Got the offset, so size capacity offset array. So what we're going to do is we're going to say, hey, you know, current size of the whole thing of where we are right now actually equals where I am right now. Alignment of next type. I'm not sure if I'm doing this right. No, I'll need to add the, yeah. Either way, we do this and then we return that. Otherwise, we're at the end. We don't have to do anything, so we just return full bytes, full size, full byte size. Build offset array. Okay, let's get some tests for this. Click on pointer to avoid. Is that like a byte type? Nope. It's 112. There it is. I mean, there's unsigned char, but I'm not really. No. Time, so it's 1 byte plus that. That's not good. Requested allocation size is way too big. Cool. go inside of here. We do that. We're going to, so we have the capacity of 1. Current size is, because this is not that. So it's currently 0. Full size equals that time plus that. Yeah, okay, makes sense. Location size of that. Okay, so let's keep going until we get a type that's not that. So that gives us 16 because we have an offset array of that 0, 4, and 8 for int, and yeah. For the total size of 16 for 8 for yeah. Int double float and char star. See, that's, yeah, see, this is what I was thinking about earlier, was even though float is only 4 bytes, so that would take it to 20, I needed the extra alignment so that, for a pointer, which went to 24 instead. So 24 plus 8 equals 32. So that's, so the alignment stuff that I was thinking of is actually working. It's working on an almost first try. Cool. Now, I wonder how this looks under this. So we're going to do, so this was pretty, what, 49? So we do the same thing here. We do that single Alex storage. And this is actually kind of a bit more, which makes sense because we're doing extra work inside of here. To fit it into a single allocation. Okay, what about getting? Like, what's the stuff for getting stuff? So we're going to have an allocation of this type. Yeah, it compiles down to just getting the thing at the offset. Plus capacity dot get of 1012. Oh, I didn't want to do that. Zero, 1, 2. Oh, pointed to. Pointer to. Yeah, it's RDI plus 8, plus 24, then it doesn't add pointer stuff. That's what the EAX is about, right? Yeah. So that's actually really nice. Compiles down really nice. Yeah, so EX is that, which is retrieving it. Or move, I should say. Moving it into the EAX register. Nice. Nice. Okay. So that's kind of, that's storage. That's low-level storage kind of done, dealt with. Again, like this, the none of the memory is initialized by this. This is just a giant, dumb space in memory that I'm going to work with. Inside of the pools. Let's close all others. That right, we got that, we got that. And it compiles down to basically nothing, which is fine. But I'm actually interesting. What if give the alignment for this? Let's say we have two ints or like void star one. Val 2. So getting rid of all the rest of this stuff. What I want to do is do dots, yeah. It's not really. I thought it would, or oh, 03. Ah, there we go. And if it was just only 3. That's what I was looking for. If I can do that. See, this will go back to Q word. Where it just adds one. But then this one will start doing some kind of special pointer stuff if we like this. Getting rid of that entirely just returns it to a whole bunch of other nonsense, which I don't really get. So I can do groups of 2, it looks like. Before it does a group of 1 and then the Q word separately for the third one. Okay. XMM, I guess, is double word. Word is 8, double word is 16. I guess, what's these quads for? LCO, oh, it's just Okay, yeah. And if it doubled, then it's just LCO again, I guess. Does it three times? Okay, I'm interested in. I know this doesn't actually make much sense quite yet, but I'm just thinking of like how I'm going to formulate access to data in the pools, that go down to storage. I'm just trying to think like, do I want to return like an iterator of some sort, or do I want to like pass po just raw pointers back and just tell myself to just deal with it? I'm just trying to see, like, if I want to iterate through items like sequentially, if I just have pointers and I put them together like that, is it faster than otherwise would be? Because if I go back to O2, this is going to be just that. I don't know if that's even good or not. I mean, that's a lot more, obviously. Tony Max is out of double words. I presume Clang will just do the same thing. Oh, cute. Really? Yeah, okay. Go back to GCC, because this is not what I want to care about. I wonder if I do it beforehand. Nope. I just want. I put the thing before. It's the same thing. Yeah, it's the same thing. Okay. What was I doing? Yes, include. We'll go with the multi storage, since that's a little bit lighter on. I mean, it's a bit slower to allocate in the first place, but it's less commands, so it kind of evens out, really. I think, actually. Back up, back, 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 back. Okay, so this was regular with all this stuff and test with an alumni, so dash 03. Like, what was the that's it. One single call to malloc for that. What? One, two, three, four. Oh, four double things. So if I get rid of one, you would get a Q word in there. But still, it's a single malloc call. Is it like automatically putting into a single allocation anyways? It actually might be. So I don't know how to explain this otherwise. Oh, no, this is a loop. Oh, my God. I am an idiot. It's a loop. That's why. Times the number of 6 times. And then a malloc each time. Instead of going for... Yeah. And then if we go back to... Single alloc. Do this. Then it becomes this larger thing. For the initialization, but it's only got a single malloc call instead. We do a lot more work here. We do more work here rather than going into malloc, doing the work in malloc in a repeat. Okay. We're going to work with the multi for the moment. Okay. That was actually, I'm going to leave it here as like the second part of actually like a three-parter maybe. Because that, so the first was... Yeah, because this is the storage kind of ready to go. This is kind of what I'm most looking for, storage. And then I'll do another part, which is going to be like integrating this storage into the state data pool instead. All right? All right. Cheers.